Hello folks, in today's video we will make one to-do list application using Tailwind CSS. Previously we have only used vanilla CSS, but in this video I'll show you how to make the same app using Tailwind CSS, because vanilla CSS is not something that is often used in the industry. So let me start by introducing you to the official documentation. And this is the official documentation of Tailwind CSS, and this is the get started page. To initialize a Tailwind project, you can start by writing few commands. So you can write npx tailwind CSS in it, and it will create one tailwind.config.js file, something like this. And inside this content, you have to put wherever is your index.html file. So I have kept it like this. This is my tailwind config file, and I have my index.html inside my dist folder, wherever I will be working. So I have put this path over here, and then you also have to create one input.css file. And then you have to import few classes in import.css, and that is tailwind base components and utilities. And then lastly, you have to run this command, and that is wherever is your input file and wherever is your output style.css file. And once you have done that, you can start working. So instead of output.css, I have kept style.css over here. So every Tailwind class will be written in the style.css file. So once this basic setup is done, you can start working with Tailwind. So yeah, let's get started. So in the index.html file, we have the body. And here we can directly add one class. Let's name it bg gray 200, and if I click on save, I have different background color. So this is how Tailwind works with inline classes only. So now let's also give some styles to our heading. So I will add another class over here, and here let's increase the font size. So I'll write text 3xl, so the font is now bigger. Let's also center it, so I'll write text center. And let's also give some margin top, so I can write empty of, let's say, 2. So these values are standard. In case you want to use some custom values, you have to use one square brackets, and let's add 50 pixel over here. And as you can see, it is much higher. So I'll use a standard empty 2. Yeah, this is fine. So now I will create one container class. So I will write input container. And inside this input container, I will have our input. Let's keep the placeholder as enter to do, and let's also give the ID of let's say input to do. And then we will have one button, and let's keep the ID of the button as add to do, and let's add a class over here. So we have our to do's. So now what we need to do? So first of all, let's also add some classes in both of these. So class and class up over here. So what we can do? So let's increase the text size. So I will write text 2xl. Text is now much bigger. And let's give some padding bottom of 1. And also some, let's say, padding left of 1. Okay. Now for our button, let's add another class. And let's change the background color. So I will write bg of blue. And let's give the 500 one. Okay, and then let's also change the text. It has not yet changed, we have to refresh. So let's give a text white. Now if I refresh, what do we see? We see one button. Now also a few more things we need to do. So let's give some padding in the x direction. So I'll write px3, and then let's also do a font bold. So we have to write font bold, and this is much bigger now. And let's also add a rounded for both of these, then the edges will be rounded and rounded. Yeah, these things are now rounded. And let's also add some padding y over here also. So py of 1. Let's see, let's refresh. Yeah, now this looks much better. Now the issue is that this thing is stacked at the left. This shouldn't be the case. So what we can do is simply go to our container. And here we will add flex, and then we will add justify center. Justify center. And now this is center. Now we will also add some marching bottom of, let's say, 6. And let's refresh. Okay, this is not working, and that is because this thing is included inside this container. So this will not work over here. So padding top will work. If I write pt, this will work. Okay, let's keep it like this only. And also after our input class, we will also add few things. Let's say margin write off, let's say two, to give some space between our buttons and our to do. Yeah. So now it seems to be good. So now we will start working on our to do container class. So this container will have all our to do's. And here, for you ease of using JavaScript, we will first of all add one to do wrapper. To do wrapper. You will see this when we use JavaScript. In our other applications where we used vanilla CSS, we didn't use this one because this was not needed, but here it will be needed. So inside every to do wrapper, there will be one to do. And inside every to do, we will have all things. So we will have one text. Let's write some to do. Catch RCS. And then we will have one class called, not class, it will be of actions. Actions. And here inside, I will have one input checkbox. And I will have one button of delete. That's it. That is one of our to-dos. And similarly, there will be other to-dos like this. So I can copy this one. And instead of RCS, let's try catch git Athena. Yeah. So it will show up something like this. So now let's start adding our styles. So first of all, inside our like to-do wrapper, we don't need any styles. It will be something like this only. So inside our to-do, first of all, let's give a background of white. Yeah, and there is an issue over here, and that is we have to repeat all of these styles. So let's comment it out for now, and later we can simply copy paste. So BG of white, and what are the other things we need? We also need flex, because these things need to be aligned correctly. So we also need flex, and also in our input container, we also need some margin bottom. So what we did, margin bottom of, let's keep 8. Let's refresh, and yeah, this is fine. Okay, so after flex, what do we need? We also need some margin and padding. So let's give some margin in the X as 8. Let's refresh. Yeah, good enough. And okay, let's also increase the font size. I think that is needed. So font size, I think it was text Excel 2XL. Yeah, much better. And we also have to align these things correctly. So justify between, good enough. And let's also give some space. So margin X, let's do some padding Y of 2. Okay, and let's also add some color to the delete button. So I'll have add one class, and I will add PG red of, let's give 500. Let's do one refresh. Okay, and also text white, that is required. So 500, then text white, and also rounded. Maybe let's make it darker. Let's make it 600. Okay, I think this is better. And we also need some padding of X in the X and Y. So padding of X, let's say 4, and padding of Y, let's say 2. Let's see. Okay, it's too much. 1 and 2. I think this is good enough. Now in our to do also, we need few things. We need some padding of X also. So let's make padding of X as 2. Let's also make it rounded. And do we need anything else? We need possibly, let's also add another thing, and that is items center. So these things are not yet centered correctly. Okay. So what item center does is, let's make it padding of Y of 4. And if I remove this item center, it will be slightly not correctly aligned. So we can keep these things. And yeah, a slightly larger to-do is also not that bad, so we can keep it like this also. So, and also let's add some gap between our checkbox and our delete button. So after our checkbox, let me add another class, and this will be margin of right. Let's give 4, and if I refresh, I have some margin of right. Yeah, so this is good enough. Okay, so now let's add the other to-do. Let's simply remove this. And let's copy along with the to-do wrapper. And after this one, let's see. Yeah, so there is an issue, and the issue is we need some margin button. So let's add Giratina. So after my to-do, so we will add the margin button in our to-do only. So px2, and then we will have some my. My of let's say 2. So what do we have now? Okay, and so it will also have one my over here. So after this px, here also it will have some my of 2. So it will have slightly higher distance, I suppose. Okay, so this is good enough. We can have to-dos like this. So now our work in our index.html is done. And as you can see, this is much faster than writing a custom CSS file. And we have a quite pretty to-do list application. So now we have to add the functionality. So we will go to our script.js file, which is already like linked in the index.html file. So in our script.js, what are the things we need to do? So first of all, we have to identify our DOM elements like we used to do for like any other app. These things are simple only. So input to do. But there is one catch. So if you have seen my video of to-do list in vanilla.js, you will see what is the catch. So we'll get that later. So first of all, I will identify my input to do, then my add to do. So document get element by ID of add to do. Let's try to console log and see if these things are coming fine or not. Add to do, and here let's see. Yeah, so we are getting, so these things are coming. And also we have to identify to-do container to append our to-dos. So document dot get element by ID, not ID this time. This is query selector, query selector, and we want to identify by the class called container. So there are many classes, but it will simply identify with the container class. Yeah, I mean this one doesn't have many classes, so yeah, that's it. Okay, so let's remove this line. And now what do we want to do? So in our add to do button, I want to do few things. I want to check if the event is clicked, and if it is, then let's do few things. We will have an event, and first of all we will check if there is something in our input to do or not. So input to do dot value, if this is not empty, then we want to do few things. So we want to call a function called display of to do. And the input will be our input to do dot value. And then what we want to do is change this back to an empty string. That's it. And yeah, that's it. And then we have to write one function called display to do. Function of display of to do. And there will be one input called to do value. And let's return for now. So what this does is simply it is checking if this thing is empty or not. So for example, let's simply do one thing. If this is empty, let's write log of not empty. And if, okay, fine, good enough. Okay, add to do is not a function. Something strange over here in line number 5. Okay. So what we have to do is add to do dot event listener. Yeah, now this is fine. Now, okay. Let me click on plus over here, nothing happens. So now let me write one A, and as you can see, not empty. So this is all that is doing. And after clicking on the plus, the A is getting removed because of this line. We are assigning empty string. So let's remove this line. And now inside our display to do function, what we will do. So first of all, we will create one to do wrapper. To do wrapper. And this one is our document dot create element of div, because it's a div. And then we will do to do wrapper dot class list dot add, and the class name is Tutu Wrapper. Actually, we can remove this class also because we will not be using it. But since we have added, let's also add it. Okay. Now, inside our vanilla JS to-do list application, what we did was we used create element methods and then class list and set attributes to set up all of these things. But as you can see, there are so many classes. It's very difficult to do it like this. So we will use one catch. We can do simply something like this, to-do wrapper dot inner HTML. And inside we will have our to-do. So here I will use one backtick. And inside this backtick, what I can do is I can simply copy this whole to-do. So let me minimize the to-do and copy the whole to-do. And I can keep it inside this backtick. Yeah. And instead of this catch RCS, I have to use one variable over here. And that is whatever is my input to-do dot value. So this does the job of all of those lines of those append child and everything, all of those things. And now we also have to add our delete functionality. Okay, so first of all, let's see if this works or not. So I will do to-do container dot append child, and we want to append our to-do wrapper. So let's write catch some other, let's say legendary Pokemon, Lapras. It's not legendary, but that's all I can think of right now. So when I click on add, it is getting added. So checkbox will work as usual because it's only HTML. We are not coding anything, but the delete is not working. So now we have to add the delete functionality. So how can we do that? So let's create one delete button over here, delete btn. And this one we are getting only after we are defining the inner HTML. So what we can do simply is to-do wrapper dot query selector. And inside this one, I have to identify this button. So how can I do that? So let's add another button name over here. Let's call it delete btn. And let's identify by that class name, delete btn hyphen btn. And then what we want to do is in our delete btn, we want to add event listener of click. And if this is clicked, what we want to do, we want to call one function, and that function will be, ideally we use arrow function, but for now let me just use one anonymous function. And you can also write one del to do over here, it's no big deal, del to do, this is the function name. And what we want to do, we simply want to remove the to-do wrapper dot remove. That's it. So now let's see if it works or not. So ideally this is hard-coded HTML values will not be removed. So let's catch Latios, add it, and then now if I click on delete, it's getting removed. So as you can see, our to-do list application is working perfectly fine. So we can simply remove these things or simply comment it out. So let's just remove this one and comment out this. And now all our to-dos will be getting rendered inside our application. So catch Zapdos, and it's getting added. Catch RT Kuno, getting added. So this thing is working fine. And if I go inside our elements and inside our body, you will see that we have all the Tailwind CSS classes over here. So here we have our, what do we have? Our body, and as you can see, we have these things like text, CSS, whatever is there. We have input container, justify, center, whatever is there, whatever. Inside container, we have this commented lines, and then we have this to-do wrapper inside this to-do wrapper. So basically everything we have defined over here, this is also coming in HTML. And if I go inside my style.css, you will see that I have all these classes also. So for example, let me go down. As you can see, we have text white, font bold, text to Excel, text to Excel. Everything we have used in our HTML, everything is being defined over here. And all of this is coming from this input.css file. So this is how you can make one basic to-do list application using Tailwind CSS. And in the upcoming videos, we will be using Tailwind CSS a lot more. So yeah, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and bye-bye.